Ben from Snowy's here, folks. Today I'm taking you for a walkthrough of the DS-1 pitch black single swag from Oztent. Hit it. The DS-1 swag is a dual skin swag, so it's a twist on a traditional swag, but offers a really weatherproof shelter for one. So I've got the DS-1 pitch black swag from Oztent set up behind me here. Now, a lot of people are going to jump in and say, that's not a swag, it's a tent, because it is a dual skin setup. It's got a fly over the top of an inner. There's a lot more pegs than your traditional swag, but hey, it's something different and maybe it kind of bridges that gap, but it does offer really good weather protection and a lot of setup options. So run through the features today and I'll lie in there and show you how I fit inside. To start with the boring stuff, it weighs about 9.75 kilos. Set up like this, if you take into account all the fabric at the ends there, it measures about or a bit over 3 meters, about 3.2, 3.3 meters. The inner tent is about 2.1 meters, about 90 centimeters width inside, but we'll talk more on sleeping space shortly. At this end, it's about 95 centimeters as highest point, a little bit less for headspace, and that tapers down to about 80 centimeters at the foot end here. So it's made primarily of the same 8-ounce polycotton canvas that Oztent have used for all their RV tents, but the main difference is if we have a look at this pitch black tech logo they've got here. So they've moved to putting this black coating on the inside of the polycotton fabric of the fly sheet. Now this blocks out, well, they say 95% of the light, so it allows you to sleep in longer, stops as much warmth or light coming inside the tent, so it cools it down a little bit. The main thing though is that it makes it darker inside, so if it is a light moonlit night, if you have trouble sleeping on those nights, this is going to make it nice and dark inside. Now inside, the other fabrics also consist of the same polycotton canvas. This does not have the black lining on the back of it though, but the same 8-ounce ripstop polycotton canvas. 65 GSM mesh within here, and there's a little bit I'll talk about these being replaceable. We'll talk a bit more on that shortly. And 350 GSM PVC for the base, which is a big bucket floor here, so nice waterproof base. The poles are an anodized aluminium, so you've got two flexible hoop poles at the end here, and at the top, I'm not sure if we can quite see it, but we'll see it when we pull this fly off later. There's a ridge pole along here that's also anodized aluminium. Now, before I jump inside, I want to have a walk around the outside of the tent, because this is probably where it differs the most from traditional swag. So this is a fly sheet. This comes off completely. You can use it without the fly sheet, and I'll show you more on that shortly. And it has this big skirt around the side here, so if we maybe have a bit of a walk around the tent, I haven't got it pegged out on this side, I'll go into a bit more on that shortly, but we've got another door here, we'll talk on that shortly, but right around the back here I've got it pegged out, and you can see this actually creates a really waterproof space or weatherproof space for the tent, so if you are caught up in really bad weather, you can use the guy ropes as well if it is in really bad weather. This creates a really good way for the water to shed off and also less wind to get inside the tent. So this is all pegged out on the bottom here. You don't have to peg them out, but it gives really good bomb-proof weather protection for this tent. There is a vent at the head end of the swag here as well, a little kickstand in there, so we can open that up to allow high-level ventilation to allow that warm air to escape out the tent and also ventilation through the tent. As I mentioned, we're pegged along the bottom here, so there's no door on this side. This is just a solid side of the tent, so it offers really good weather protection. And then at the rear here, once again, got all those skirts coming right down around the base here, so really good protection. Got another vent at the back here with a little kickstand in there, so we can open that up and allow more ventilation. And the guy ropes at the end here. Now, at this end of the tent, there is a small vestibule. You can't access it from inside, so you probably need to just stuff underneath like this if you wanted to store stuff in there. I'll just pull this out and try and show you how it looks. You've just got probably about 30 centimeters of space here from here to here just to store probably your boots or something, so stick your boots under there at night, peg this out. It's going to keep them nice and weatherproof, and the benefit of this is you don't have to worry about weather, wind driven rain getting in underneath this awning, because if you peg all this out like this, it's offering you really good protection in there. So your boots are going to stay nice and dry, even if it is really windy and wet overnight. So back around this side, I just want to cover off on the door configuration. So you've got two entrance points here. The first one being this long section here. So there's a zip that runs underneath this orange flap here, and the same at the foot end here. Undo this one as well. And we can roll this up to the top here to keep it up and out the way, if you like. There's these tabs, three of these tabs along the top here, so we can actually secure this up. So you've got it open during the night if it starts off as a nice night, but you've got it there to roll down if it does happen to rain during the night. Your other alternative here is to set this up as an awning. Now you'd need optional swag poles to do this, but you've got eyelets here and also an eyelet in the skirt on the end there. You're probably best using this eyelet here and pegging this out like this. This will kind of hang down like a little gutter, I suppose, offer a little bit more sort of shade protection there, but you can set that up as a little sheltered entrance to your tent. Now on top of that, if you are seeing really bad weather and you do want to peg the skirt out along here, because this is a long section of the tent, so this is going to flap around the most. So if you wanted to peg this down to offer really good weather protection inside, you can do that, leave this section sealed closed, and then just use the entrance on this end of the tent here. So this portion, this side of the end here, is a vestibule entrance inside the tent. So we can just roll this back and secure it here, a little bit like a hiking tent, I suppose. We secure that on the side here. We've now got the storage vestibule here and also another entrance inside the tent there. So about 70 centimeters of measurement from here to here. So you're not going to fit a lot of gear in there, but you could probably, if you had to, I guess, use a trangie or something just in here as enough space for a bit of weather protection. Now, I want to show you inside the tent. Because of this pitch black fabric, it's really dark inside. So I'm actually just going to throw the fly sheet over to the side, and we'll show you how big the interior is and a few other features there as well. Okay, so I've just got the fly sitting at the back there. So this inner tent is, I've just got one loop around there, but that's independent, that's freestanding. We can see now we've got polycotton canvas at 65 GSM mesh through the middle here. This is the anodized extender pole or ridge pole that I was talking about. And we've got color-coded poles here too. So orange at this end lines up with the orange tabs, and then the black end for setup. Black tabs for the black pole. Pretty simple. Now this measures about 210 centimeters. Sleeping space inside is about 210 centimeters in length and about 90 centimeters in width. The mattress is just a little bit smaller than that. Now one really cool feature of this swag is they've used a fine mesh here. A lot of swag go and use a really heavy duty mesh. It's still a durable mesh, but I guess what Oztent have maybe done is understand that this is probably one of the weaker fabrics in any swag. So they've made this entire section replaceable. So this zip operates to obviously allow you to roll this up and peg it up in the middle here, so you can have a completely open sleeping space if you like. But it actually runs all the way around, and you can remove this completely. So if I zip this right up around to here, you can see that that's now just hanging on the pole in the middle there. So I've removed that entire section. We've now just got an open sleeping space here. So I'll put this back on to get back inside the tent, but I just want to show you how easy it is to take on and off if you do need to. So that zips up again, and I want to zip this up so that I can get inside the tent and show you how much space I've got in there. So leave the zip there. I'm just going to throw this over the top because I want to crawl inside the swag and show you the features in there. Now this is the mat that's included. It's a 5 centimeter mat. I wouldn't say it's really thick or super firm foam. It's going to be easy to roll up, but you can always upgrade any swag mat with another mat. So any mat that's about 200 centimeters in length and about 90 centimeters in width is going to fit in here. The only thing is it's going to make it a little bit firmer to roll up. So whether you fit it back in a bag or not is another question. You probably need to roll it a few times to squeeze the air out of those self-inflating mats. We've got another video to show you how to do that. Now this cover is removable. Got a zipper along the top here, so you can take the foam out, wash that if you like, but for the most part, you can probably surface clean it or throw another sheet over the top. It's easier to wash the sheet. Now inside the tent, we've got a few features, a few little storage pockets, which is pretty cool. So this mesh pocket attached to the side here, just for a bit of storage, keep your keys, phone, etc. at hand at night so you don't lose them. Same thing features on the other side here. And you've also got a couple of little pockets at the head end here, so slightly heavier duty mesh here, but that's sort of, it's a bit rounded on the bottom, so you can probably fit a water bottle in there. And on the opposite side here, slightly higher up, same thing features. Now it's higher on that side because below that is actually a power access point. So this is a spot where we can get 12 or 240 volt power inside the tent and hang a lantern in here. To hang the lantern, if we have a look at the top here, we've actually got tabs that feature, which would be useful for a 12 volt light bar. So there's one at the end here, 2, 3, 4, and 5 of those, a little elastic strap. So you could put a light bar in there if you like, or just hang a small lantern on it. You probably want to put a big lantern on there. It's going to hang down really low anyway, but a small lantern inside a swag is certainly going to do the job. At the head end here, we have a mesh access point. So if we're not using this access point here, we can access the tent in and out through here as well. And at the foot end, we've just got a mesh panel, which is a vent. So we can't open that, so we can't access that vestibule like we talked about from inside the tent here. We need to get that to that from the outside, but this allows ventilation through the tent and to that vent that features in the fly sheet at the rear there. Now the height of the tent, as I mentioned previously, tapers to this end here. So you've got about 70 centimeters of internal height at this end here. And then back up at the head end here, it's just over 80 centimeters from the top of the mat. So if you put a thicker mattress in, you're gonna lose some of that space. And lengthwise, about 210 centimeters, as I mentioned, of sleeping space, and about 90 centimeters in width, but the mat, as previously mentioned, just under that. Now I'm 185 centimeters in length. There's tons of space in here for me. So big feet as well, so plenty of height for my feet. If I lay down, I've got, let's put my hat off, I've got plenty of head space. My feet are at the end, so I've got a bulky sleeping bag. It would probably be touching the end there, but if it was a cold night, I'd have the fly sheet on. And our ventilation too, it's not going to be an issue with condensation and heaps of shoulder space here, heaps of room. I could probably sleep in here with my dog if I wanted. So lots of room inside the tent here, and I can see straight up at the sky. If I've got this zipped up during the night, I'd be lying here stargazing all night. Obviously, if the fly sheet was over the top, that'd be a different story, but for a nice warm night, this is the perfect tent with tons and tons of ventilation. That is a run through of Oztent's DS-1 pitch black swag. Maybe a tent, maybe a swag. I would say it's in the swag category, but it's a little bit different than the traditional swags and offers an alternative that gives you really, really good weather protection. If you find yourself in really bad weather with that skirt around the edge, peg it out. You can keep all sorts of wind and rain out of it. You can check these out online at snowys.com.au, where you'll find them at our lowest prices every day. But if you do have any questions, let us know down in the comments below. Subscribe to our channel for all of our latest and greatest information, or check out some other cool Oztent products like these ones down here.